And to think that I would be doing the final battle in the grand stage that is, well, the Imperium's Throne. Can't remember the original name, but hey, what you gonna do? But anyway, greetings, ladies and gentlemen. Smiling Trent 4 here, and welcome back to some more Tales of Berseria. As in the last session, we finally made it here to Innominat, and it's caused an earth pulse in the upper level of the central area. Yeah, that's an interesting way to name all that off. You're welcome. As we far away through Malakim, demons that look like Malakim, which is basically the same thing, and bunch of mini-bosses around and around, it was quite a hard time. Such a hard time that I had to grind off the screen just to, you know, make sure we're ready for today. So, thank you, mini-bosses. You saved our butts from the final boss, ironically enough. So yeah, if you want to see all of that, don't know why you would want to, unless you like puzzles or some skits, maybe just me going on a surf war over and over again, then go check out the previous videos and descriptions playlist down below. Again, you probably could get away with only seeing the first episode, and that's about it. Or maybe the second episode. Yeah, the first two at least. That's what I recommend. Yeah, that's coming from me. But anyway, today, as you can no doubt tell from the title of the video, this is the finale, the Tales of Berseria, or at the very least the story, because, as I mentioned at the very end of the last session, once you go through that portal up there, if I can get a better focus, yeah, good enough, you go through there, that's where our objective lies. And with that, we know what we're doing. But of course, before we go in, we have to be ready. Now, there's good news and bad news for my grinding experience. Good news, yes, we are at level 66 to 67. Of course, Vel is the higher of the levels, because main character, you gotta have her. We are to our big levels, and as a consequence, we got everyone all their arts. Everyone is maxed out with what they have. There's nothing left for them to learn. Everything that they have is already in their arsenal. And I've been customizing in Velvet accordingly. And yes, I just said Velvet. These guys I have not, unfortunately, been prepared for. I've not had a lot of time, unfortunately. Or at least let that cross my mind. And that's part of the bad news. The other bad news is, well, I didn't exactly do a lot with the equipment. I equipped certain characters with new items that you can get here. You know, I got items with a mithril bracelet, Velvet has the mithril blade, Malak as well as the secret histories. Elmer has a topaz spear, which is actually pretty cool. And there's Rokuro with his topaz daggers. And of course, Magilu's still got the witching hour. So not much to change in the original scheme of things. So yeah, not much of that. I'm kind of disappointed. Wish I could have done more. But hey, I think it'll be pretty good. And another thing to add to the good news, I managed to restore our consumables to their maximum level. At least the stuff that we need and that we can actually restore. Wish we could get more melon gels, but not that easy, unfortunately. And something I found very interesting. You know that Tetra spell that we got on Mayulu? You know, one that allows her to use all four elements after absorbing a certain amount of spells? Well, turns out, she is the only character to have three individual mystic arts. And yes, I said individual, I might get to that later. But yeah, the host of 49 pulled L2 upon performing the Tetra Detonator. Consumes 5 BG. So she has Ascending Angel, which is normal, Good Grip, which is fire, and the host of 49, which is water. Of all the characters to get a maximum of three, that's kind of saddening, because at the very least I want to see one of Velvet. You know, with our lethal pain and annihilating crash and all that. Although who knows, maybe we'll get lucky and she'll use that during the final battle. Who knows? I can never be too certain. But yeah, that's basically it. Not much else to, bring up. We've done everything we need to, we're all as ready as we can be. Only thing you think to do left is head on over to the expedition.
Take a look at this.
Ah, dang it. Yeah, I've been trying to get all the materials and all the locations I haven't already. You know, all the question marks, trying to fill those out. Not again. I'm just gonna go back to, oh yeah, Albania. I forgot. We got this next, last time. Or I got this during the grinding session. A civilization with the power to transcend time and space is said to exist in the heart of this continent, while the Rangetsu style originate in the region of Japan. Interesting, don't you think? I say we visit there.
Show them how Ifrid's crew can sail.
Yeah, get going, mateys! Even though I won't be able to, view the whole thing if we're going through the final boss fight, the credits will, overlap any of this. But, it is what it is. At the very least. But yeah, guys. This is it. Artorias and Anomenon are beyond that gate. Please say we go pay them one final visit. Dread Knights! Assemble! Da-da-da-da-da! Go!
I can feel him. Anomenon is just up ahead.
Finally, time to repay my debt.
You just like saying that, don't you?
Aw, you saw right through me.
Oh, come on, it wasn't hard. Nobody here is gonna do anything for anyone but themselves. I can't deny that.
Your wheel is yours alone to hold.
That is our creed.
Yeah, like I said, the star is right up there. Also, can't believe I forgot to mention this, fashion equipment changes. Big ones. Like how Aizen now has bangs and his 10-gallon hat back. Love said I've got rid of his glasses. I don't know, it kind of seemed a bit weird to me after my last cutscene. Eleanor has both her earrings still. Rokuro is probably one of the biggest. He's got glasses and a set of headphones. And Monkey Lou, I've replaced her her earring with a rosy corsage because, yes, I like that a little more. Okay, now that's everything, let's get up there. Artorias! Anomenon! We are coming for you! And how fitting, Velvet's theme plays here. And there they are.
Sorry to keep you waiting, gentle shepherd. The Lord of Calamity and friends are here to see you.
I can't wait to strike down the world's greatest swordsman.
You picked a fight with the Ifrid pirate crew. Now we're here to finish it.
Lord Artorias, I follow my own will now, and I'm going to stop you.
In my sword lie the hopes of mankind, the potential for a perfect world. Do you really believe that will without reason can break it?
Your sword is strong! But it's still only a weapon, just like ours.
Why don't you test that theory? With your life, of course.
Ever since you hit me, I've had this really annoying feeling in my chest. But I can't figure out what it is.
Then I'll just have to hit you again and see if that helps.
I'm sure I'll feel better after I eat you.
Arthur! I finally have an answer to your question. Why do you think that birds fly? Birds fly because they want to fly. They don't need a reason. Even if their wings may snap and doom them to die. They don't fly for anyone's benefit. They don't fly because they were ordered to. Birds fly because they want to fly, and for no other reason!
So that's your answer.
Yes. Because that's who I am!
You were always like this. That sort of foolishness is what creates the demons and plunges the world into tragedy and despair.
Then you drive the demons out! Isn't that right, Shepherd Artorias?
That has been my plan all along.
Artorias and a Nomenaut! Leads to fire, resistant to normal and wind. Yet you, on the other hand, are resistant to fire and water, but weak to the earth. Alright then! You know what to do. Question is, who do I aim for? I've got a feeling that if we go for Artorias, and Nomenaut's gonna try and heal him. So
I shall suffer all our times.
Last one, Loppy!
Rising Falcon!
Nice try! Get over here! Ow, okay. Alright, not bad. Uh-oh. I don't want to trigger a Mystic Aura if he has one. Ooh! That's impressive. Fancy trick you got there. I'm gonna save you though. Yes! Step out of the way! Look out! Oh boy. Oh, I knew it! Primal kill! Oh boy. No kidding! Okay, eeny, meeny, miny, where is it? Eisen! Nope, that's all down. You need a grape gel? Wait a second! I got six souls? When did this happen? This is gonna be fun! Uh-oh. No. Ellie! Heal me! Thank you. Ow. Okay, next. Oh no, not me! It's not gonna end well. Mother. Alright.
I can't find you.
Grab an extra soul. Nice try. I know you're Shrek. We've almost got this! Get back here! Ow, down, heal. Oh, come on, not again! Yeah, I'm really glad I'm going for you! Because you are a real pain in the neck!
I can't find you.
No! Screw your annihilation beam, fool! Okay! You back here! Don't run from me! So, almost. Will you just fall already? Thank you. Okay, now for the real meat. Meet to Earth. Does that have any specific, sets? Not just this orange dragon. Alright. Let's set this to something else, then. Oh yeah, the fine that one. Let's even test that out real quick. Or at least show it off to you guys. Since I already know how it works. Okay, first things first, though. Alright. Right, still there, nice technically. Okay, now go for it. Oh no, you don't! Crack through!
Think you can dodge? Just try! Perfect mayhem! Let's go!
Ow. Nice try. So, please, for me!
tenacious demons.
He's the reason, right there. I'll take care of you! Stand aside, Velvet. Not happening!
Have my comb.
That was the comb that Laffy gave me. Not you, Inominat.
Of course. I'm Inominat, now reborn. And you're the Lord of Calamity. Oh, Artorias. I'm hungry. My stomach is empty. My chest is empty. My body is empty, too. It hurts. It hurts so much.
It looks like we won't be able to harvest despair by eating you anymore. Well then. Birds must fly. Because they possess strong wings. Mankind must be suppressed, because it possesses great sin. Malevolence, tragedy, war, anger, tears, even love must all be suppressed. With
even
the grace
love.
Of my beating wings, I will grant humanity the tranquility it deserves. Inominat! Come, devour my despair. Man, here we go.
He's becoming a Super Saiyan God Super Saiyan.
You know me, nuts are madness!
The very first official transformation.
With the full might of my Armadas, I shall suppress all creation!
Armatize Artorias! Now's the real deal! Lead to fire and wind, resistant to water and earth! Okay. Meaning, how many we want to go for? I have it in my arsenal, actually. Where is it? Not Slag Assault. Cerberus Wave! Oh, actually, it's right there, isn't it? So if I just do this... I just keep using fire attacks... Yeah, let's go for that. Searing Edge with Cerberus Wave combo. Let's take him down.
Artorias was filled with this much despair?
I was holding it in check this whole time.
Wait, what the? Hold on a second. I hate when it does that. How do I do this?
And you would have become a demon. The power of Artorias' determination,
but also proof of his true nature.
Here, please! You broke me! Here's your justice! By the order! Here! Where is that?
This is Artorias now, it's just one army threat.
Wait!
time, that's for sure. I can only get that extra soul. I might be able to take care of him. Might be able to do just enough. Ow, okay. I gotta block that, that would be great. I got this soul! This is what I need. And that's this special is brought to you by the ACA, otherwise known as the Active Hours Association. Program that keeps my computer from restarting in the middle of a session. Thank you, Lord. Anyway. Hey! Holy! Blocking that does a lot of damage. Also, it's just me, but volume's killing in my ears, so I'm gonna turn it down a little bit more. That's the district. Yeah, much better. Oh, hey! Thanks for quickness, Einstein! Oh, Frank!
Now suffer for that!
No, I can't die.
Holy mala. I probably should heal up before something else happens to me. Now come on! Would you get that out? Thanks for the extra soul, maybe. No, you're not getting me. I will sear it into your face! Yeah! Try and activate now! Yeah, wait a long... Get distracted! I got six soul! Wait for it! Ow! Survive! Enough of your illusory force! You? Love of hold still! much faith in that! And I can't even function. Aizen! Give me this! Never mind, don't need it. It's over.
You've grown strong. Let us settle this here and now, Lord of Calamity.
What you told me once, long ago.
On the day of the opening, Velvet, the Arthur you knew, died that day. was always there, in the back of my mind. If only it hadn't been Silica and my son were killed that day. If only it had been you two instead.
I thought the same thing, so many times. If it had been us, then I know you would have fought to save the world for us.
It's true. I wanted to save everyone. Such a pity.
Goodbye.
It's over.
I'm hungry. I'm hungry. I'm hungry.
No, it's not over yet.
No!
Even though I was scared, even though it hurt.
I know.
I drank that gross medicine. I stopped myself from doing what I wanted to do, eating what I wanted to eat. I tried so hard. Why won't you give me this? I hate you, Velvet!
Luffy said, you tried really hard. But you don't have to fight anymore. It's time for us to rest, Luffy.
Velvet will let Inominat devour her forever, with her forever devouring him in return. She will seal him while keeping him alive. An infinite contradiction, a perpetual cycle of destruction.
Velvet, you can't!
You and I are part of Inominat, V. If he dies, both of us will die too. I dug my own grave. But you...
I don't care about myself! I'm not scared of dying as long as I'm with you!
The apple.
Good. Then die. But only after eating, living, doing everything you want to in life. I really am horrible, aren't I? Just a selfish failure of a human being. But despite all that, you still saved me. With your unwavering kindness and strength.
I didn't do anything! Velvet, you were the one who...
Fee, you must have seen it during our travels. Humans spend their lives in constant struggle. That's why they end up making so many mistakes. Even my poor brother. That's why I'm asking this of you. Please live. I was the cause of so much chaos and destruction. Help the world I ruined. Help people like me. Help the weak. This is my last selfish request.
That's not fair!
I'm truly sorry.
It's okay! I forgive you! Velvet! I love you!
Aww.
Thank you. I love you too. Fee.
Now you show up. Pretty irresponsible, if you ask me.
You're mistaken. Without Innominat, the balance of our power will crumble.
The elements will clash in violence and ruin. The world will take millennia to recover from the destruction.
No!
Uh-oh.
To save the world from destruction, a new Imperium is needed. A Malak of great strength. An indomitable will.
I'll do it. I'll be your new Empyrean.
Hold on a second, Lafayette! You can't just...
Let's hear him out.
You are part of Innominat. You're not lacking in strength. But the question here is one of your intent.
Just what do you wish for this world? What will you bring unto its denizens?
I want people to have another chance! A chance for them to right the wrongs born of their fallible spirits! To give those who dream of flying the time they need to rest their wings! So that in their strength, their weakness, their cruelty, their kindness... These imperfect humans will one day stretch their wings toward the horizon!
Make your dream a reality, young Imperial.
The power to purify the malevolence as a shepherd.
Rubbed off on him. Hasn't it, Lafayette?
Huh?
So the dragon... this whole time...
Is that really Lafayette? But... how?
That is his Empyrean form. It's also proof of his determination.
Like an oath?
Yes.
do I frighten you now, Eleanor?
Not at all. You've matured into a fine man.
So was that flame your true power as an Imperium?
Daemons. Malevolence. Did that fire get rid of it all?
No. I'm still very much a demon.
Mm-hmm.
The silver flame has the power to cleanse a soul of its malevolence and change a demon back into a human. But it doesn't have the power to change people's hearts.
It just gives them another chance at life. Isn't that right?
Sorry. Looks like my sins run too deep to fix.
That's fine. It's a part of who you are, Rokuro.
You're still a softie, aren't you?
Well, that's just great.
Huh?
Most of the exorcists are wiped out, but the evil and chaos in people's hearts lives on.
Thus brings Zestiria.
It's gonna be tough going from here on out, folks.
Yes, it will. Even still. Humanity will never lose its hope, or its prayers for a better future.
Well said!
The Malakim have free will again. Some may even lend you their aid to help create this ideal future of yours.
I will spread the word. This world is now under the protection of the Imperian Lafayette.
Would you mind not calling me that? I don't think it really fits who I am now.
I guess you're right. That was Velvet's name for you.
Okay, what should we call you then?
How about his true name?
Call me by the name Eleanor gave me. One who lives. That's what Lafayette means. Translated into the ancient language.
And just like that, the plotline for Zestiria was born. Well played, Square Enix. Wow. I was just about to say Square Enix. Wow, I'm such a doof. Good job, Bandai Namco. Bravo. Bravo. You somehow managed to make the plotline of Zestiria more relevant thanks to this game. And considering Zestiria's story was pretty boring before, that's quite an achievement. But yeah, I guess we can just go on from there with my personal thoughts. Story, as I said, better than Zestiria for many reasons. One, it's not your basic generic story copied and pasted, where in Zestiria it's just like, boy goes on his journey, takes out the evil, comes back home, sort of, blah blah blah. That was kind of boring. But in this game, not only do you have the tides turned, but you have the birth of the Shepherd, the birth of the Lord of Calamity, back when these two were completely opposite sides. Lord of Calamity being our hero, or I guess in this case, heroine, and the Shepherd being our villain. Which I like. You don't get many stories, especially mainstream stories in games and movies, where the big bad villain is actually the hero, which I personally enjoy as a concept. And as for the characters themselves, well, I can't really say anything bad about them. Velvet fits her role very well, going from the sweet, innocent girl who's lost everything into, you know, an agonizing demon, Therian, who just wants vengeance, but towards the end, manages to, you know, put that all aside to do what's right. Lafayette? Don't need to see much about him, although I'm not gonna lie, his change into Maltellus really surprised me, because one thing that was going through my mind throughout this entire game was, okay, so obviously, you know, Nau's gonna be put down, and that would be it. And I thought that that would somehow lead into the third game in the Zestiria trilogy, if there is one, where because Maltellus is awoken, you know, that means they bring it back into chaos, and it's just this never-ending cycle or something. But no. The real Anomna is put away for good, whereas Lafayette, Maltellus, is the true one. The one who really will bring purity to the world. So, that was awesome. Just, I can't begin enough. As for everyone else, there's not much else to say about them. I like Aizen, how he was integrated into this game, you know, being Edna's brother of all people. And just seeing how he functioned compared to his sister was always interesting. Plus the little tidbits every now and again was, cool. Rokuro, I love not only because he's voiced by Bendiskin, but also because of his, you know, I will do anything to repay my debt, which is something that I personally follow in my life. You know, if I do something, I will repay me something. Like, if someone does me a favor, I want to repay them back to the best of my ability. And, you know, vice versa, if I pay someone back, I expect them to do the same. It's selfish, depending on which case you look at, but nonetheless, not much else to say. Magilu? I like her earth change, going from the cuckoo one to realizing that she was one of the original legates and thus, you know, fighting along our side. Although, I'm still puzzled as to her true emotions, unless it was to, you know, just take vengeance on Melchior, in which case there's that. Honestly, the only character I find the stalest is Eleanor, because, you know, like, she's just there to serve as the vessel for Lafayette. And now, who knows what she's gonna be? Who knows, maybe she'll be the next Shepherd. That would not surprise me. In fact, I'd actually find that pretty cool. The only remaining legate, by technicality, becomes the next Shepherd. That would be awesome. Gameplay-wise? Honestly, I think it's kind of tied with Zestiria. Well, yes, I do enjoy the, you know, the game-breaking soul mechanic, which was much better than how Zestiria implemented things, and the fact that you can actually customize things if Zestiria couldn't, still not sure about that. I still think they're pretty even in how much I enjoyed them as a thing. Really, the only difference between the two is which one I enjoyed with both. I'm enjoying the gameplay here with the story in this game, whereas only in Zestiria, I enjoyed the story a little bit, but I was more there for the gameplay. And I do like how in this game, they actually kind of, you know, downgraded things a little bit, you know. Because in Zestiria, things were hard. If you go back to my playthrough, I had trouble towards the, like, latter half of the game because of things. But with this game, it wasn't too difficult. Granted, part of that might be me just doing some extra grinding off-screen, but I don't know, it didn't feel as challenging, which is not a bad thing. For a normal difficulty, that is perfect. And I didn't even need to change difficulty once, so I think I can say that's a win-win, for sure. You know, visuals, not much else to say there. They're the same as Zestiria, and I enjoy them here just as much, if not more so. Actually, kind of combining that with the gameplay, one thing I wish they had done was the ability to actually go on the ship, like on the Valenaltia. You know, actually just, like, swim around and, you know, visit places or something like that. You know, it's cool that we had the quick travel system. I'm grateful for that. But I wish they would have done more with the shipping. And that's about it. Is there anything else I can think of? The music. I love the music. If not, just Burns... Or, sorry, Flo's Burn intro. But the... But just the themes from, like, Velvet's theme, the final boss fight. And just, you know, the themes from every now and again. I think they work. Well, of course, I'm more of a fan of the battle stuff than the radar things. Oh, and hey, look at that, all the references. From Fantasia to Zestiria. How fitting. And you know what? Yeah, that is pretty much all I can say about this game. But that reference there is going to lead me on to the next thing. So by the time this goes up, it is the 23rd, I think? Yeah, the 23rd. And this will be going up on the 27th, I believe. Just one day before the next game that I want to do some recording on comes out. So before all that, I'm going to be doing a first for myself. Not just for the channel, but for any Tales game in general. I'm going to go for the cameo battles, because in this game, they make them very simple to get. And I'm honestly excited for this one, because I did a little digging in my spare time. And let's just say, these cameos very much excite me. Now, I haven't done the whole thing, I want to save some of it for the actual thing. But yeah, that's what I'm definitely doing next. And once that happens, maybe I'll do some extra stuff, I have no idea. But yeah, I think that's about it. I said all my thoughts on the game. I enjoyed everything about it. I've given ideas of what I'll be doing next. So with all that said and done, guys, that's going to do it for this final episode, The Tales of Berseria, The Story. If you guys have enjoyed this entire adventure, of course, as always, make sure to leave a like and comment down below. Share this video with your friends, should you feel the need to. And of course, if you are new here to the channel, want to see more Tales of Berseria as it comes out daily, or at the very least, till the new game comes out, and anything else I might throw into the mixer, then go ahead and subscribe. Join the Dread Knights, the Von Altia, Velvet's crew, in the past of course, and everyone else in our quest to protect the video game universe, one game at a time. But hey, until next time, this is Mysha before signing out. Have a great rest of your day, take care, and I'll just let the credits take care of themselves. And I'll catch you guys next time.
It is the beginning. Mankind will go on fighting without end. Just as they did. Still spread their wings to seek the horizon, just as they did. For every laugh, there will be tears. This world is cruel and unforgiving.
Hey, come on!
Even the gods themselves don't know what the future will bring. Fearsome and kind. The day will finally come when your dream becomes reality. Until then, I will kindle a flame within me, burning strong and bright.
Velvet Crow. Proof of seeing the end of the tale. Now you can go another round, or aim at completion. Well, at least we'll be halfway through there. That's my intent. Congratulations on completing the game! You can now save your data and later load it to continue playing from just before the final battle. Additionally, New Game Plus is now available from the title screen. Selecting this option will allow you to start the game anew using your complete save data. Of course, like Tales fashion. Again, thank you for that. Of course, we'll save our data. Consider this save data 21. Why don't you choose to save over 20? Well, as I said, I'll be saving that for our next adventure. But alright! Catch you guys tomorrow with another video.